Hi everyone, and welcome to this sneaky peek behind the Love Like Hers edit. You're going to get to see the timeline that I'm working from at the moment. What you're looking at here is one of the original teaser posters that was designed by Dan Anscombe for me way back when we were looking at funding the film. This is well over a year ago now, I think. Serena was the model. She doesn't star in the film, but she was the face for our little teaser poster campaign back in the day, which is very nice and did the trick. So anyway, just to bring you up to date with the edit, I currently have Mark Talbot Butler's last version of the film. He's had to fly out to Los Angeles and is now unavailable to do any more on the film. So he's done as much as he physically can. He's got the film into great shape, but there is still room for tweaks and a few little fine tuning on the edit here or there. Certain things that I'm not too happy about, and I say not too happy, I'm not too keen on, and areas that I think we can improve on the edit. So he literally sent over his edit. He was using Avid, and I'm using Final Cut Pro, so there's the whole converting file, importing file problems, but he basically sent over all the elements that he had from his Avid. So we've got the EDL list, the edit decision list, which is, it works fine on the video side of it, but for the sound and all the audio, I just couldn't import into my Final Cut Pro for love nor money. It just didn't recognize the files, compatibility problems, and to get the software to get Final Cut to recognize the files costs hundreds of dollars, and I wasn't going to go down that route. So these are all the files sent to me from Mark, from his Avid. I can't use any of the audio, but I've managed to match up his video EDL to the rushes, using the time code and all that sort of stuff. So I've managed to match that up now, going through, and I've resynced up all the dialogue as per Mark's edit in Final Cut Pro, which I will get to right now. So what you're seeing here is this was the first edit of the film that I did on my own. As soon as I got the rushes back from the labs on DV cam, I digitized the footage and decided that I needed to do an edit of the film just for my own peace of mind, really, just to make sure that I've got all the footage needed to be able to send over to Mark for him to actually finish the edit. So here's all the various bits. This is, of course, the video tracks, and then all the audio. So you've got the dialogue in these two tracks, and then you've got various background sound effects and temporary music and various other bits and pieces put together. There's some dialogue overlapping and from other scenes just to kind of help. And so there you go. So that was the first edit, which the feedback I got from that was good. So a select few got to see it, and generally the feedback was good. So I sent that as a reference edit with all the footage over to Mark. He then came back and did his edit, made some notes, made another couple of changes until we got to the final edit from Mark. I then had to import all the video using his timecode and EDL, and then had to resync all the dialogue, which you can see here. Once I'd done that and I had his edit of the film cut for cut on my timeline, I then got to work on fine-tuning it and moving a few things around. I had some ideas that I wanted to introduce that I thought helped the film. So I did that, and what you see here now is my tweaked edit of what Mark Talbot Butler had done, and I think it's probably 95% finished now as far as the actual moving picture element is concerned. There's a lot of sound and everything to sort out yet, but as far as the actual film itself, the what you see, it's about 95% done. You see here we've got some text track. These are instructions for Russell Wharton, who's going to be doing the special effects in the film. And there's various little elements that need adding in, so they're mainly for his reference. I'm not going to show you any of those. I hope you'll understand that. I don't want to give too much away on the film. It wouldn't be fair for those that have actually pre-ordered the copy on DVD and so on and so forth. I don't want to give too much away. You can see a little still there, and you get a general gist of it here. So so I've done the dialogue. I've done a retweet of the tweak of the edit. I'm now just adding some temporary background noise, sound design stuff down here, some different various elements. And then we'll do a test screening. We'll do a test screening on that. And then from the feedback that we get on that test screening, I'll do a further tweak on the edit. And then we'll have another test screening. So two test screenings in total. More edits, more different ideas, and filling any holes that the story might have. And then that'll be it. The picture will be pretty much locked. I'll then send this timeline over to Niklas in Sweden, who's the composer. He'll then add music to the film. And then we'll be working, hopefully be working with some Foley professionals to add all the various little sound elements to the film. And then everything will be sent over to Mike Aiton, who's the dubbing mixer, to bring all the sound together. And then, of course, there's the whole grading and various other bits and pieces that that need doing as well. So still plenty of work to do. I'll show you some behind-the-scenes video before we go any further. This is the team in our... Well, this is our hospital location, our care room location, which is actually a hotel, believe it or not. And we managed to kit it out to make it look like a care room, a hospital care room type place. You see, we got hired all the bed and the bedside cabinet and everything in. This was a nervous moment for the crew. Very expensive camera equipment. And we had our actress underneath that, and we didn't want it to fall off, of course, so they were making sure that safety-wise that was spot on. And I'll just show you one more behind-the-scenes video. Same location again. This is with our actress Margaret Clooney, actually in position with the camera hovering above her. That's Tom the gaffer getting all the lighting and everything in place, and getting everything ready for us to shoot. And there's a little sneaky peek of the frame of Ella, the character Ella, in her care room. And there's Dave, the camera operator. So there you go. That's a quick update and a quick insight into the timeline of the Love Like Hers edit. And keep your eye on the blog for more updates.